We've all seen a situation like this. Someone asks a question in an online community or posts some sort of struggle about how their website's not working or the freelancer they were working with didn't really do that good of a job. And then everybody jumps in the comments section and says, well, I could have done that better for you. Or send me a DM and I'll fix this for you really fast and really cheap. Or this is what happens when you go with a cheap freelancer who doesn't know what they're doing. You should have hired me. Blah, blah, blah. Whining, complaining, and not being helpful at all. To land high-value projects like a $10,000 one-page website project, you need to stand out from the crowd and the noise and be different. Be the solution. So here's my winning strategy on how to do that and still land high-paying clients. Hi, welcome to Creative X. My name is Brad Hussey, and I'm a professional web designer. If you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe, hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of the videos, and stay up to date on all of our latest content about the art, business, and craft of web design. If you missed part one to this video series on how to land high-paying projects like the $10,000 one-page website project that I recently landed and completed, pause here and click the card on the screen that's popping up and watch part one, then come right back here in this second video. In this second video, I want to talk about the contributing factors to getting high-paying clients and how to effectively present yourself as the perfect candidate for a potential high-paying gig. So this is my winning strategy that I'm going to reveal to you that helps me land high-paying projects like this one every time I get a client. So let's get into it. So let's start with some contributing factors that got me this project. So you might say like, okay, well, you got experience, you got an audience, you got some level of influence and connections. And so you have all of this advantage over me, the new person who just started the last 6 months, and there's no way I could do that. So first of all, I'm not saying that out the gate getting started, you should expect to land $10,000 one-page websites and have that be a standard expectation for you. That's not realistic. Eventually, yes, it should be realistic. And if it's not eventually, then you have a problem on your hands. You're not doing something right. But what I'm trying to say here is that this wasn't about me. This wasn't about those advantages. Now, I did have advantages like soft skills. I learned some things. I have some skills to bring to the table. I know how to communicate. I knew where to be and what to do and what to set up. But it wasn't the person who hired me went, you, I've been looking for you all this time and you have all this influence or you're clearly the person. I was basically one of many other people who could have landed this. I just happened to land it. And I think I know why. In fact, I do know why, because I've done this on other occasions as well. So it's not just like happenstance or luck. It's just kind of a winning strategy. And I want to pass that on to you because you can apply it to your business as well. So let's talk about those contributing factors that landed me this project. I'm in a few online business communities. Some are free, some are paid. Kind of like this. Creative X Crew is an online business community for professional designers, developers, people who create websites for clients. We're creative professionals here. And so what I try to do in these communities, the ones that resonate with me, the ones that I like, and the ones where my target audience tends to be, is I simply try to be a goldmine of value and service to the other members when they have questions or problems that lie within my zone of genius, which is web design, branding, digital marketing, these things. If another member wants feedback on their website or their branding or their marketing strategy, I'll usually chime in with a super helpful in-depth answer, or better yet, a video response that genuinely is helpful and eradicates the problem for them, gives them the strategy to solve the problem. Like, it's kind of like a no holds barred, Brad's coming, Brad just entered the room and just made that go away for you. Like, fix that for you. And what I'm trying to do here is I'm just trying to be stupid helpful. And I don't ever expect a response. And I don't aim to try and get a response. And I think this is where it works. So I don't end the video after like giving them feedback or suggestions or showing them what to change or fully pulling up their site and reworking some of the code or redesigning it in Figma or showing them how it can be like quickly redesigned and turned over in Editor X in a matter of minutes. Like, I'll show them that stuff and show them how to do it and give them what they need to do it. And I don't end with, if you want me to do this, like send me a DM or here's my email or here's my phone number and let's take care of business. Like, I don't ever close with a closing statement. Like, it's kind of just like, I end with, hope that helped. Bye. That's it. And it's like that elusive, wait a minute, you're not trying to sell me? Approach, I think works to my advantage. And so in a sense, like, that's my way of opening the line for them to contact me, because I'm in a business community, I'm there to help. My profile straight up says, I help these people get this, like this. Like, that, it's why I'm there. I don't need to, like, you know, drive home the fact that, like, you can contact me and make it sleazy. Like, I just wanted to be helpful, and that's it. And if you don't contact me, I actually don't expect you to contact me. Nor do I need you to contact me. That's the other thing. So I just treat it as if they've paid me $1,000 to answer the question. Now, here's another thing. Everybody else tends to answer on that post in the community with, like, here's what I can do. I can help you. I just sent you a direct message. Like, please respond. I can do this for cheap. I can do it for $500. Like, it's sad how desperation just takes over an otherwise, like, poised professional. What I'm trying to say here is that I just serve first. I don't expect a DM, and everybody else is trying to serve themselves. They're desperate. It's just oozing desperation and saying, well, I could do it for cheap. I could do it for fast. I could do it like this. Here's my quick little line of feedback. And there's no help at all whatsoever. And it's very obvious. What's way better? The person who's like, I don't need you to, like, send me a message and to, like, I don't need to beg you to be a client. And I don't even take on clients that often, but here, I just solved your problem for you. Save the video and take care of business. Nobody else here is helping. I'm sorry that nobody is helpful. I don't say that because they're all my people in the community, and we could all do a lot better if everybody answered with an amazing question. And great, we've all destroyed the problem for the client or the potential client, and they can pick who resonates best with them. So that is really a really key important contributing factor. Is I'm in this community, I'm in communities, and I just genuinely add value. You can apply this to any community you're in, starting immediately. Creative X Crew, not excluded from this. If somebody has a problem or a question, don't just sit and watch and go, oh, maybe somebody will answer that question that I know how to answer. I just don't want to spend the time typing. Just, like, fully go all out, pull out all the stops, solve the problem for them in front of everybody. You're a champion. That person is very grateful for you, and other people get to learn what is a valuable contributing community member that is leading with service. And so I pay like $60 a month to be a part of this particular community, and it's easily made me tens of thousands in return. By just doing this, by adding value, answering questions, and connecting with people, even just saying, like, send me a question, send me a DM with a question if you need clarification, so we don't muddy up this thread. And I'll just answer the questions. Like, it's not like, hey, book a call, here's my hourly rate, here's this. Like, send me a message and we'll come up with a deal. It's just like, here, I'll just help you, and that's it. And so there's the first contributing factor. Is be present and valuable to relevant online and offline communities where your target audience or potential partners hang out and complain together and need help. You can be the champion. You can be the hero. And that will pay dividends. It does. It always does. It leads to people sending you work. It leads to referrals. It leads to companies and brands taking notice of you. It leads to potential customers ultimately contacting you. And that's what happens. So that's the first contributing factor. Has nothing to do with me. It just has everything to do with an approach that you can use too. In any community that you're in, LinkedIn, social, or here in Creative X Group. There's no reason you can't. So maybe I'm giving away a trade secret here of mine, but hey, I mean, if this means that somebody experiencing a problem in a community will get quality answers more often, then hey, like, consider this my public service. Besides, most people won't do this because they're lazy. Just it. Like, putting on a webcam and spending like an hour answering, researching and answering a question just to answer a question seems like a waste of time. Sure, you can believe that all you want, because the person who realizes it's not a waste of time and it is valuable service and it feels good, you're building equity in that community. You're also like building a connection professionally, referral source, potential client. I mean, there's lots of value there. The community owner, like, they notice it, like, it's not for naught. But if you're lazy about it, well, you get nothing out of it. So you get what you give in communities. So this is exactly what I did with the client. So they posted about a website problem, wanted feedback. It was urgent. The website was not good, to put it kindly. And they were in a really tight situation with an urgent deadline coming up. And this is what people were going to see. And I felt sad for them because nobody was helping. They were just kind of like saying, oh, if we just change it to green, or if we just do this, or it's so nice, or this or that, or, oh, I feel so sorry for you. Like, I could have done this so much better for you for half the price than that stupid freelancer, blah, 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 blah. And so I was just like, man, this person's not getting any help. It's just a bunch of people moaning. Ugh. So I shot on my studio light, turned on my microphone, flipped on the camera, did a little research, went through, and I gave them a design review. Rapid fire design review. Showed them, you know, like, what, here's what's not working, and here's why. Like, you're asking for feedback, you didn't pay me for it, so I'm gonna give you feedback and approach it objectively. Also, I'm gonna show you what could be done better. So what I did, and because I'm using this tool, is I fired up Editor X and I was like, I'm going to rework this entire page quickly in Editor X, showing them how to do it. It's free to sign up. You can use the wireframe template. Boom, 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 done, 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 done. It's all responsive, it looks amazing. Oh my gosh, how incredible was this? It took me a matter of 15 minutes, condensed it into like a 5-minute, 6-minute video, showed them how to do it. Here's Editor X, you can sign up for free. And if you want a domain, we'll do a premium plan. So there we go. Hope that helped. Cheers. That's what the video was. And I had no expectation at all of any response. I just wanted to be helpful because nobody else was helping. And even if other people did help, I would have helped anyway. It's just, that's what I like doing. So I just walked away. I just carried on about my business. And that's the second contributing factor, is people provide unrestricted value and service without expectation of anything in return, for free, without any sense of desperation, and move on. That is key. So what happened next is, I think, really important. Though I walked away, my systems that I had in place did not walk away. So I have, and this is not special to me, all of you can do this. By the end of today, you can have all this generally in place. So I have systems in place to capture valuable opportunities and place them in front of me when they are ready. Like, asynchronously, happens just all in the background while I am eating dinner, pretending to read a book, like making coffee, or like hardcore working, doing office hours, like whatever it is. I have these systems in place so that captures these opportunities and puts them in front of me when they are ready. So a couple weeks goes by and I wake up to an appointment notification in my calendar that's been automatically scheduled through my Calendly, which is an automatic scheduling tool, with an attached message from the person whom I've helped in the community. A very excited message saying, more or less, oh my goodness, wow, yes, you. not their words, mine, but that's the essence. So I didn't schedule the appointment. The potential client did, which means they saw the video, they saw the answer, they downloaded the value into their world, realized the value, decided to open my community profile in the community. So they click on, who's this Brad Hussey guy? Boop, slide out comes, there's my community profile. And by the way, this is a circle community that I'm in. So like they have great tools for creating an awesome profile. And they saw the picture, read the bio, checked out the website, read the summary of who I am in the bio and who I help. It's a very specific profile for that community. And then they click through to the site, which is a relevant landing page to that community, read the words I wrote, sold themselves on my value, and scheduled an appointment using the automated booking tool through the landing page, from the profile, from the video. And I wake up to a red hot, ready to buy prospect whom I've already served, sold, and I just need to have a brief conversation with them to ensure that we're both on the same page and that I can be of genuine service too. And if we both agree, then that's called closing the deal. It's not salesy, it's none of that. It's just like everything comes to that moment where you kind of go, yeah, this is gonna work. Let's do it, let's move forward. This happened asynchronously while I was sleeping because I created the digital assets and put the systems in place to accept incoming opportunities and funnel them to me when they're ready. This is the third contributing factor. It's not specific to me. Anybody can do this. Now that you know the secret to getting a potential client's attention and providing them tons of value that helps position you as the expert and the perfect candidate for the project, well, it's time for the sales call or the sales conversation. So in the next video, I'll talk about how your sales conversations should go, what not to do and what not to say, and how to underpromise and overdeliver. Subscribe to the channel so you don't miss part 3 of this series. And if it's up already, well, click the video to keep watching. See you in the next one.